December, when somebody say your name, I'ma home feel like December. Welcome back to another daily video. My name's Joel from Rumi Official and Famous Artists. Can they sing or is it just autotune?
Which one is it?
We're gonna find it out today, maybe. Or we're gonna look at some performances, at least with and without autotune. Let's just get into it. The first one is Adam Levine, famous from Maroon 5. They have been a big band for like, I don't know, 20 years or something. I remember listening to them when I was a wee boy. Let's have a listen.
There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain. When I believed in forever, everything would stay the same. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain. When I believed in forever, everything would stay the same.
Just the last note there was a little bit off, but I would say he sounds very, very similar. That was really good. I've heard worse performances from Adam Levine, honestly. I think he sang on The Voice once and it just wasn't that great. But I think people gotta remember that, like, every once in a while you gotta, like, you can't hear yourself properly on stage or you have an off day or whatever. Here he sounds great. He definitely has the potential to sound really good, like, here. Another thing to keep in mind though is that this is an acoustic version he's doing right there. You can hear himself perfectly. I find that singers sound a lot better usually when they do acoustic versions of their songs. Anyway, let's continue.
I feel like December, when somebody say your name. I feel like December, somebody say your name.
That was good. It was a little bit of a wonky thing there exactly in the beginning. Let's have a listen.
I feel like December.
Yeah, he kind of lost it a little bit there.
Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day.
It's looking like he's tensing his lips a lot. It's like, cool! And it's kind of like to the side. Like, it's very, oh!
Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. Everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say.
We talked about this before, but obviously this song is like Pachelbel's canon. Is it Pachelbel or Pachelbel? I don't remember. It's classical music. Head on over to Two State Violins if you want someone who knows about classical music, but it's obviously very based off of that, if you heard it. And you gotta do this dance when you sing it. That's an important part. Anyway.
Here's to the ones that we got to. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through.
Actually, a little bit of a difficult melody to sing. I'm surprised though that such a talented singer hasn't practiced it a little bit more, because he's struggling just slightly to get up on those notes when it's like the whole la la na 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 na. It's just very fast. Here's to the one that we got. It's a little bit of a tricky melody, I think. You gotta remember as well that we're comparing to the tuned version, which is very perfect. Autotune has taken us to a point with vocals where they don't sound robotic, but they still sound like superhumanly amazing. And who's one to argue with that? Isn't it nice that recordings can sound this good? I think so. But there will be people who are angry about that sort of statement, so I'm just gonna say, leave a comment, tell me how wrong I am. Hey, let's continue.
Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back, memory, bring back.
And he's saying memory instead of memories. I'm angry! Does he even know the lyrics to his song, or is he just struggling? I wonder if he's used to standing up and running around more when he's singing. I would say that I get like at least 20% worse at singing when I'm sitting down. Just everything's so like, nothing flows natural when you're like, sitting here. But that was, yeah. We're just having fun here, guys. We're laughing a little bit at famous singers, okay? Let us feel good. These guys are multimillionaires and very talented. We can look at little flaws and be like, ha, Adam Levine. More like Adam Pitchin. I tried. It's a little bit pitchy merch right here. I have miniature pitchy merch right here. You like it? It's actually part of this little doll. So many teddies sent me this. Amazing. He can even... Oh. Anyway. Oh, I feel so bad. Okay, I'll get him. He's just chilling on top of the guitars now.
Hi.
Next up, we got Doja Cat. Let's freaking listen.
I keep it juicy, juicy. I eat that lunch. Yeah. She keep that booty, booty. She keep that pump, yeah. That natural beauty, beauty. Yeah, yeah. I keep it juicy, juicy. I eat that lunch. She keep that booty, booty. She keep that plump. That natural beauty, beauty. Yeah, yeah.
Her voice sounds so broken in that Genius interview. Do you guys hear that? It's like, what's up with that? She's not singing it in the same key either. So the original key is... So it's C major in the autotune version and... Actually, it was just one semitone off. She's one semitone lower. But listen to that. It's really not projecting well here. I'm glad I don't have an eye tracker on.
You can see it
from the front, wait till you see it from the back.
She's not sounding great in this interview. Again, I always say this with Genius interviews, they're not there to sing, they're there to talk about their lyrics. But still, like, shouldn't you just sing okay, at least? I think when you sing in a low key, whatever, that's fine. Like, no one really cares, because they're just kind of like supposed to show what part of the song it is, what part of the melody is it. But we'd have liked a little bit better singing. Come on, Mrs. Cat. Miss Cat. This is disturbing, by the way. This is gonna haunt me in my dreams.
But I wanna know how long it take to pull my pants up.
Can she say the N-word? I guess everyone can technically say it. I'm not gonna say it. Doja Cat. Here we go. Her father is South African.
Yeah, okay.
Mother Jewish American. I'm surprised. Looks like a white girl with a fake tan. Can I say that? I'm gonna say that. Anyway, let's keep going.
I don't buy it with a cellulite.
I like that melody, the whole believable. That's a nice, like, little melody. I love that a lot.
He said the body unbelievable.
Yeah, not the best performance. I'm sure she can sing better, but she sounded destroyed. Maybe she had a concert the day before, B, partied hard before, C, recorded a long time the day before, or D, someone came into her at night and just put something down her throat that destroyed her vocals.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Let's not dive into that too deep. Allergic to edgy jokes. Today is the last day you can buy this special edition Roomy glow in the dark hoodie. Just look at it. If you don't buy it now, how are you ever gonna live with yourself? You won't be able to get it. Link in the description. Next up, we got Breland. I do not know who Breland is. Let's look it up. He doesn't have a Wikipedia page yet, but apparently he has a song called My Truck, which is the next country trap hit. So, kind of like Old Town Road. Let's have a listen.
You can drink my liquor, you can call my lady, you can take my money, you can smoke my... You can drink my liquor, you can call my lady, you can take my money, you can smoke my...
He's got a great voice. Man, I love that tone and that little run and everything. That was awesome. You don't expect much when things are like trap and auto-tune-y and stuff, but every once in a while, you get a good one. You get a bam. Not saying he's got like the biggest range or anything, but that tone and pitch is good, fam. I mean, this is obviously a joke. Way more obviously a joke than Old Town Road. Old Town Road is funny, but like, I don't know, this just feels way more like he's not standing behind it. You know what I mean?
Don't touch my truck. Screw. Screw. Don't touch my truck. Screw. Screw.
Slightly pitchy there, but that's a really weird vowel to sing on. Screw. He wants that perfect nuance of that vowel as well, because it's, you know, the skirt. I can't even do it. Like how people say skirt, like in that Jason Derulo song, right? He's like, what's it called? Pull up? Skirt! Skirt! But like he does it perfectly, but it's a very specific, like almost back in your throat type vowel.
Skirt!
Skirt! I don't know. It's difficult. Also, if my singing wouldn't sound perfectly on pitch in one of these videos, it's always just something wrong with your phone or something wrong with your computer. I'm always perfectly on pitch. Let's keep going.
V8 engine with the windows tinted. Boy, we came from the bottom, got it out the mud. V8 engine with the windows tinted. Boy, we came from the bottom, got it out the mud.
Dude can sing. It's really nice. Super, like, classic blues. I like it. It's swaggy. It's good. It's nice. Makes me feel... In this type of genre as well, like kind of like little blues thing, just a little bit of
pitchiness
can actually be a plus, because you really want that raw feeling in a song like that. But of course, they tuned it really hard in the original version.
Homie, don't get it twisted.
Oh, that's gonna be hard to sing without autotune, those falsetto things.
Keep it semi in a hemi, red coat full of henny. My head is coming plenties, for real.
It was good, but that's hard to make sound good, those like weird falsetto things with those vowels as well. I'm impressed with him. Big applause for, was it Breland? Anyway, next one, we got Taylor Swift. Oh, we haven't done Taylor yet? That's crazy. With and without autotune, let's have a listen.
I remember when we broke up the first time, saying this is it, I've had enough.
Oh, this is gonna be hard to sing too. It's so rhythmic and got a lot of ups and downs in the scale type thing. Loads of lyrics. Gonna be interesting to hear this. Taylor maybe isn't known for her super pitch accuracy. Not saying she's a bad singer. I just think she's amazing as a storyteller and as an artist. I think she really has something. A lot of people would hate on Taylor Swift. I think she's great. But, big but, massive but. From a pure pitch perspective, we're probably not gonna see something close to the tuned version.
We hadn't seen each other in a month when you said you needed space. What? I remember remember when we broke up the first time, saying this is it, I've had enough. Cause like we hadn't seen each other in a month when you said you needed space.
Wow, those are a lot better than I thought.
Then you come around again and say, baby, I miss you and I swear I'm gonna change. Trust me, remember how that lasted for a day? I say, I hate you, we break up, you call me, I love you. Then you come around again and say, baby, I miss you and I swear I'm gonna change. Trust me, remember how that lasted for a day? I say, I hate you, we break up, you call me, I love you.
Okay, now we're getting a little bit higher. Maybe we'll get a little bit pitchier here, but Taylor is really good with her guitar. Bit there, not too bad.
This time, I'm telling you, we are never, ever, ever getting back together. We are never, ever, ever getting back together. We are never, ever, ever getting back together. We
her guitar playing's tight too. I'm impressed. This is great. I mean, she's a full-time touring artist, so what do you expect? But still, I'm like,
bruh. You go talk to your friends, talk to my friends, talk to me. But we are never, ever, ever, ever getting back together.
Wow, that was really good. Big applause. Wow. Taylor, what are you doing? You're sounding good. That's not allowed. No, I'm kidding. I'm always really happy when there's a pleasant surprise with these. Sounded great. Next up, we got Njal. Is it Njal Horan? Is that how you say it? So basically, in Sweden, his last name means the streetwalker. Njal the streetwalker. Well, you know, the other word that starts with a W. We can't say that word.
I like the way you talk. I like the things you wear. I want your number tattooed on my arm in ink, I swear. I like the way you talk. I like the things you wear. I want your number tattooed on my arm in ink, I swear.
Sounded almost exactly the same. Sounds good. Pretty much exactly the same tone-wise as well.
When the morning comes, I know you won't be there. Every time I turn around, you disappear. Cause when the morning comes, I know you won't be there. Every time I turn around, you disappear.
I mean, it sounds good, but it's also like, I wasn't expecting anything else. He's an experienced live performer, and it's pretty easy to sing. What are you gonna say about it? Nothing. I'm not saying anything. It's good, but I wanna hear more. I wanna hear some registry. I wanna hear some pazoos. Pizzazz, sorry.
I got love for you. Nice to meet you. What's your name? Let me treat you to a drink.
That's funny. Didn't he used to be really blonde? I swear he was like the blonde kid in One Direction. Yeah, totally. Anyway.
1 minute you're there, the next one you're gone.
Okay, you fell off a little bit there.
You know what I need, you know what I want. You know what I need now. You know what I need now.
Seems like it's just messing around, really. But yeah, he sounds good. Niall the Streetwalker, very well done. Okay, so we did a $10,000 singing competition the other day. Check it out here. It got tons of really, really talented singers. However, it is 40 minutes, so make sure you got the time. But it's amazing. You will not regret it. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.